हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू आवर चैनल टफकॉन स्वनिर्माण। हमारे पिछले वीडियो में हमने आपको बताया था अबाउट सेल्फ रीडेवलपमेंट एंड मुंबई बैंक की सेल्फ रीडेवलपमेंट से लेके क्या पॉलिसी है उसके बारे में। आज हम आपको ले चलते हैं हमारे एक सेल्फ रीडेवलपमेंट प्रोजेक्ट में, जो एक म्हाड़ा प्रोजेक्ट है, चारकोप ओरियन कोऑपरेटिव हाउसिंग सोसाइटी चारकोप कांदिवली वेस्ट में के सेल्फ रीडेवलपमेंट में बनने वाले प्लान्स, जिसको डिज़ाइन किया है गोल्ड मेडलिस्ट आर्किटेक्ट उदय कनाडिया जी ने, जहां हम टफकॉन्स निर्माण प्राइवेट लिमिटेड अपॉइंटेड है एज अ प्रोफेशनल पीएमसी फॉर सेल्फ रीडेवलपमेंट। एंड सेल्फ रीडेवलपमेंट से लेके सारे सर्विसेज हम उनको प्रोवाइड कर रहे हैं उनके प्रोजेक्ट में। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द प्लान्स।
So we have worked out, our architect has worked out various options. So there are majorly two layouts, and in those two layouts we have residential, purely residential configuration. Then we have residential and partly commercial. And again in the second option, the layout is a bit different, and then there's again residential commercial. I'll show it to you. So in option one, the layout is on one floor, there are four flats. So there is a jodi of 3 BHK, 3 BHK, and jodi of 2 BHK and 2 BHK. And in option 2, there is an option of 3 BHK and 2 BHK jodi, and again 3 BHK and 2 BHK jodi. In option 1, if we check only residential, then we get around 33 floors, the building height would go up to 33 floors. For residential commercial in option 1, we go to 31 floors. Similarly, here in option 2, there are 33 residential floors, and residential commercial we simply go for, then we come up to 31 floors in total. So in the first option, the street, we have taken parking, purely parking on the street. On the first to fifth floor, we have taken podium parking, which is accessible through a car lift. There will be two car lifts. On the sixth floor, there will be an E-deck. So what's an E-deck? It is a floor above the podium where we can plan all the amenities, the garden, sitting area, senior citizen areas, children playing area. So this whole, the garden area, everything can be managed on the podium, on top of the podium, which is called the E-deck. And after the sixth floor, from seventh floor to the 33rd floor, we'll have the residential, that is the habitable floors. We'll have around 26 residential floors. Like I said earlier, we are also trying for a VP quota, which can bring about 1,900 square meters of enhancement in the project area. So we can plan another 5 floors more than what is this. So if we get that, once we get that approval, we can go up to 38 floors. So there will be totally 31 residential floors. Ground plus first. So when we come to residential and commercial, the ground and first floor we have planned commercial. Because the first floor comes up, there's commercial, so from second to fifth floor there will be podium parking, again accessible by lift, car lifts. Sixth floor will be E-deck area. 7th to 31st floor will be the residential habitable floors. That will be 25 floors of residential area. And once we get the VP quota permissions, again we can add another 5 floors over here. So the building will go up to 37 floors. And it is the same with option 2. Just the layout has changed basically. Here there are the flat layouts will be changed. The rest of the features are the same. So the entire thing is the same, similar just as it is in option 1. Sixth floor deck. 7th to 31st floor. And here if we get enhancement, there would be an increase in 5 floors of residential habitable area.
Steve,
yes.
Steve,
plus ground floor. That is stilt on the ground, plus 5 floors without commercial. So the plan without commercial, so stilt will be parking and 5 floors will be parking. This is the parking layout, this is the plot layout basically. This is Baba Sahib Ambedkar Road on top. And this is the 19 meter road inside. Sorry, 9 meter road, 9.13. So we have planned two entries, one is over here, one is over here. this would be the entrance lobby. Is it visible to everyone clearly? Right? This would be the electric substation, the electric meter box in the room. These two would be the car lifts, this would be the drive here, and these are the parkings which are there on the ground. Here. Anyone can see the brand, right? Total car parking on the ground is coming up to 23 total car parking on the state. So from 1st to 5th floor, the podium parking, total car parking will be 21, 2 car lifts to come up, and this is the layout on all the 5 floors. Okay, so on each floor we have 21 car parking spaces, like that 5 floors. Still plus 5 floors with commercial. Now there will be commercial on ground at first, and on top of that we'll have the parking. So these, again the entry would be the same, the entrance lobby, substation area, meter box, car lifts, total car parking 21. Now here this would be shop 1 and shop 2. Shop 1 would be around 1080 square feet. Shop 2 of around 1183 square feet. And then the first floor flat, so office 1 and office 2. Office 1 is around 1763 square feet. Office 2 is around 2,344 square feet. And from 2nd to 5th floor, we can have the parking area. So this is the plan which we have considered as an option. We haven't taken it in the feasibility. If you go for commercial, there can be an enhancement in the profit of around 6 crores. That we haven't considered in the financial working as of now. We have made plans for that. And now the 6th floor, that is the e-tech area. So here we have planned the fitness area, fitness center. There would be a car lift which comes up. We planned 10 parking spaces. And society office area, total car park will be 10. Proposed plan option 1, that is the option 1 layout. So, this is a typical floor plan. So here this is flat number 1, 3 BHK, 1000 square feet. Flat number 2, 2 BHK, 645 square feet. Flat number 3, 2 BHK, 645 square feet. And flat number 4, 3 BHK, 1000 square feet. So this is, these two are 3 BHK jodi and 2 BHK jodi. Okay? So this is 3 BHK and 2 BHK jodi. So this would be the entrance. You enter from here. The living room. Living room area is around 214 square feet. Dining area 41 square feet. Then the kitchen. Common toilet. This is the master bedroom. So master bedroom is around 147 square feet. Master bedroom is around 176 square feet. Then there is bedroom number 2, which is 147. Bedroom number 3 is 130 square feet. The rest is the passage area, and 2 bedrooms have attached toilets. Two BHK flat of 645 square feet. This would be the entrance. The living room area is around 170 square feet, and apart from that, we have the dining area of around 31 square feet. The kitchen area 80 square feet. The common toilet. Bedroom number 1, that is the master bedroom, is 130 square feet. It has an attached toilet. Bedroom number 2 is 120 square feet. This is how the building is going to be. So these are the number of flats. These are the corresponding floors. First, the lift would be either entry, exit, car lift or parking street. So lobby lift, driveway, the all the shops according to the plan which is selected. Then the podium parking, respective flats and the refuge area on the 7th floor, 14th floor, 21st floor. This is the schematic section, basically a tentative elevation of how the building will look. So here would be the podium and this would be the building. So we have around 69 units for sale in residential and 4 units in commercial. Proposed plans option 2, that is the second layout. So here we have 2 BHK and 3 BHK together. So first is 2 BHK, 645, 3 BHK, 1000 square feet, 3 BHK, 1000 square feet, and 2 BHK, 645. So this is how we combine 3 and 2 here. This is the 3D rendering that we have made. So it gives you more clarity regarding the plans. Again, this is 645. Rera carpet comes to 669. This is 1000. Rera carpet comes to 1042. Similarly, it has a mirror image of here. 2 BHK flat and 3 BHK flat. So this is the typical flat layout. In both the plans, the flat layout are more or less the same, but there is a minor change, so I'm showing you both separately. So here again, the living room area is 190 square feet. Dining area 12. Then there's kitchen, common toilet. The master bedroom is 135 square feet. With on above that, other than that, you have the toilet area separate. Then the bedroom area, that is the second bedroom. This is the 3D rendering. So this would be the entrance. You enter from here. Living room area, dining area, kitchen, bedroom one. This bedroom one with attached toilet, wardrobe area, and this bedroom two. You have a little bit of chhajja area over here that we have planned.
What is the
RERA carpet area? RERA carpet area is, according to RERA, the carpet area definition differs. So the internal walls are not counted, are to be counted in the carpet area. So when we give you carpet area, that is purely the open space basically. Physical carpet area that you can see, but when RERA calculates it, they consider the inner walls also. So that is why the RERA carpet area is higher, slightly higher. 3 BHK, 1000 square feet. So here again the living room area is 200 square feet. Apart from that, you have around 50 square feet dining area. Then there is the kitchen area. Kitchen is around 100 square feet here. Toilet, that is a common toilet. Then your master bedroom. This is the master bedroom, the attached toilet. Bedroom number 2. Master bedroom is of 181 square feet. That's a very good size. Then bedroom 2 and then bedroom 3. This would be the entrance. So, this is the 3D rendering of the 1000 square feet flat. Living area, dining area, kitchen, common toilet. The master bed, this is the master bedroom with attached toilet, bedroom number 2 with attached toilet, and bedroom number 3. So for option 2, this would be the tentative basically layout of the building, entire building. So the respective floors and the flat sizes. So again, there is a refuge area on 7th floor, 14th floor, 21st floor. And there is one odd size flat over here, that is 346. We've taken it to consume the entire area, so that was the balance which we've adjusted there. The whole sales basically. And this is the schematic sectioning, how the elevation will look. It's a 2D of the elevation. With the refuge area, your terraces, overhead tanks, and the podiums, commercial shops, depending. So again, here we get, if we go for commercial, we get 4 units of sale. And 62, 63 units for sale of residential.